neighboring friends. I was among around 50 students who went today to visit our friends in prison. And after meeting them, it was a huge relief that I experienced inside me, that they were all with so much energy and they were all waiting for what is happening. They were all waiting for us to speak what is happening in our university, and they were all spread with smiles, and they said that they're really all right there and they really don't have to worry about them, and they could read and they are happy with all the facilities that they have, and they were hoping that they would come back soon, at least on Monday night, and would have together have dinner with us, so many of them, so that we're really wanting us to be back and have dinner with you people. So I really hope that they come back soon and we'll be able to join with them and move on with the struggle. And actually I'm very scared to speak in public like this. So it's long time that I wanted to speak, so I've literally written down some of that have come out of my mind. So I would, sorry that I would read it out rather than speaking like this. I'm really sorry for that. A long time to speak, to write and pour out all those broken memories that I haven't still expressed, at least to myself. All that we have been going through last many months is very well inside me as images. But to articulate it in words is what I find the difficulty I'm going through, and I'm sure many of my friends are also facing. To speak about it, I want my ears to only hear the slogans that we have been raising. I want my ears to hear the screams and cries of us in rage. Since 17 January evening, we all have been going through the worst kind of trauma that the state, the police and those who are in the bloody power have instilled on us. Many of us managed to come out of the traumatic situation, still many caught in that bad condition. I am aware of my privileged position. Today, it is with shame that I carry most of the identities that this hierarchical Brahminical society has imposed on me. I can see today how with my caste and other privileges, I have been part of the problem that we are talking about here. While I may not be able to undo these, the space this movement has taught me is still teaching me many, many things. And I think it's high time for many of us to understand and acknowledge the privilege that we carry and then move forward with the struggle. It is because of this privilege then that I was never questioned till this day for being involved in this movement. And my friend, who is a Dalit, was insulted verbally many times for being involved in this struggle from the same teaching faculty. Coming to the incident of 22nd March, the main accusation that they imposed on us, on the students, was of vandalism and that they we were carrying weapons. And vandalism, thank you so much for enriching my vocabulary for I literally looked at the dictionary and tried to know what is exactly vandalism, because I couldn't find any such kind of things there. And you were talking about weapons. And yeah, of course we were with weapons, we were literally going to our classes. Most of us did not know that the BC, the so-called BC has come there, and we were going with our pen and books to our classes. And I'm really angry that I missed one of the interesting discussions that we were going to have that day on D.N. Jha's myth of holy cow. And I had to go to come to BC's bungalow to see the executive council puja with liters of milk. And I'm sure that they are, the police and the BC are afraid of those weapons, the books and the pen that we have been carrying. And when after the lathi charge, what happened was they again attempted to attack on us. They again came, the police ran behind few students and faculties. We were standing in front of the humanities building. And then they again came there and said that there is a limit to freedom. And the police came to us and said that there is limit to freedom. Yes, of course there is a limit to your freedom. But you police cannot trespass the boundaries of our universities and suppress the students by physically and verbally harassing them. There is a limit to your freedom when you are no longer morally, legally able to remain as a VC of our university and then still shamefully sneak into this university. And there is a strategy that the police uses while they attack you, especially girls, and I've also experienced that. Even when they were attacking us on 18th January morning and 22nd also, like, they would literally pull your clothes, lift your clothes, remove your shorts, so that they think that they would shame us in that way. And they think that by doing this they can shame us. If we girls have ourselves neglected the patriarchal notion of associating one's honor and dignity the shawl we wear around, then how do you dare to think that you have really demoralized us? That's what I have asked the police. And yeah, I've heard that many of they were calling our Muslim friends who are Muslims as terrorists. And I would like to say that none of my friends here are afraid of your Brahminical fascist power, and they have no fear to assert their faiths and have no fear to assert their identity as Muslims, as Dalits in this university. And in the month of January, I want to recall an incident where some of us went to physics department where we were like boycotting the classes, and we had to happened to have an argument with one of the faculties. And one of the faculty said that he doesn't know what has happened and don't want to know also. He just worried about his students. Then we said to him that you need to know at least what happened in the past in your own department, which Senthil was pursuing his PhD. And this provoked him, really provoked him. And what he said that he really shouted on us and said that you don't know what is physics and you don't know what is our department. And we replied to him that, and I would like to repeat it again, that yes, of course, sir, we, many of us, do not know physics, but certainly we have learned a lot what life really is and are proud that we are not like you. And it is because we haven't forgotten the past. It is because our eyes and ears are wide open to what is happening to us and around us that we are united and are firm enough in our position now. The more you suppress us mentally each day through various means, the more are we becoming strong and the more will we raise our voice to fight against injustice. When I was having again a conversation with some of my friends about the happenings, they asked me, do you really think is this going to make some difference? And don't forget that you all are fighting against those who are in power. Is this really the right time to fight, is what they asked. And they asked me to be practical enough. Yes, of course, I don't believe in an utopia when a correct time would come to raise our voice. And I do believe we all are practical enough to fight back and reply to this fascist people democratically very well now and right now in this university space. And to those who express their anxiety that where will this struggle head to, or this going to change anything, I would like to say that of course things are not going to change completely today or tomorrow. But the space that we have now, the freedom that we have claimed now, is because of the long-legged struggles our friends did in the past, and we will continue our struggle. I remember one of the articles that I read, which was written by the alumni of this university, about the past where Dalit students had to prepare their own rice and had to go after the dinner time in mess to take some curry for them. They were denied the mess and they were literally had to stay in their own university as non-boarders and were denied the mess cards. And it was recently, it was only with one of my friend, like when the faculty asked one of the Dronacharyas, you asked him, have you really come here to study or go to Delhi and protest? Like, going on verbally, like insulting him in front of the class, then he shut his book, he closed his book and said that, yeah, we want to win the struggle and want justice for Rohit, and that's what we are doing and we will continue to do, then only the Dronacharya's mouth was shut up. And at the end, I would like to ask all of you, think, as are we actually going to, like, all of us are worried about a course research that is going on, and maybe after 1 month we'll be, most of us would be finishing our courses. Are we actually going to take or receive our graduation certificates where this so-called BC of nowhere would share the stage with us? I would like to request you, all of you, to think about it. Are we really going to go to that stage and receive the certificates where he would be sitting? And by that, I have an appeal that all of you, please go back to your departments and sit with your students, convince them, and make a consensus that none of us would go back to our classes on Monday, at least till our faculty and our friends would get their way and come back and join with us. We need to really boycott the classes and be here and remain with them. At least we can't go to the court and give our extended support. Thank you so much.